Welcome to the online lecture of Computer Integrated Manufacturing and Automobile Engineering. I am Milan Trivedi, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. So in the last class, we had started with a new chapter, that is of flexible manufacturing. We understood the definition of flexible manufacturing and we were discussing about the automated material handling system. We will continue with that topic with the new subset, that is automated guided vehicles. Now, talking about these automated guided vehicles, we are having a different varieties of guided vehicles which is used in a particular factory. Right? Some of the particular guided vehicles which is widely used that we are going to discuss today. The first one is unmanned AGV trains. Right? The appearance of this particular guided vehicle is like a train. Right? But this particular entire setup has been run in an automatic way. That's why the word automatic guided vehicle has been used. Now there are different ways to make that particular setup in an automatic way. But depending on the technology which you are using in your factory, based on that, the particular setup is been given. The second type of AGV is a AGV pallet truck. Whenever you need to lift a very heavy object, say for example, mild steel plates, which is having weight of even 1 ton or 2 ton. So such plates can be easily lifted with this kind of pallet truck, right? Which is having a jaws like appearance, which can lift the object very easily. But these are automatically or programmably operated. That's why the word AGV has been given. The third type is the AGV forklift truck, right? The appearance is very much similar to the earlier one, right? But this kind of setup is normally used when we need to have this container type of object which is required to be lifted and placed somewhere, right? So instead of using the trains or the manually operated forklift, we are having the AGV forklift, right? Whenever we are using the flexible manufacturing system. The fourth one is AGV unit load vehicles, right? In this unit load vehicles, we are having a rollers arrangement on the top of its body, right? And the particular workpiece material is rolled on the top surface of this AGV unit load and it can be easily carried out with this end of AGV unit load vehicles, right? The fifth one, that is the AGV light load vehicles, which is used to carry out various low weight workpiece materials, right? The basket has been provided on the top surface of these AGVs and in most of the electronics industry they are using because the electronics parts are very lighter in weight. And as you see over here, we are having this proper guided path, the black colored line, right? That may be acting as a sensor even, right? Following to that, the particular guided vehicle would be moving on that particular path. The another one is a AGV assembly line. And as the name suggests, it is this kind of AGV is used to carry out the different assemblies of the particular object, right? In most of the automobile industry, we are using this kind of assembly lines, right? In which the different vehicle bodies is been carried out on the particular AGVs, right? And the different parts are being assembled together in the assembly line. Now these are the different benefits of using the AGVs. First is the timely material movement. The second one is we will get the increased control over the material flow. The third one is the less chance of the product damage. Another one is positional accuracy, because the guided vehicles would be moving only the particular path. So obviously we can get the better positional accuracy. And the last one, that is greater help in the hazardous environment. See, we are using the guided vehicles, right? So that has been run automatically or with the help of certain program. So this kind of setup will be very much useful in many of the chemical industry or even in the mining industry, right? Where there are chances of hazard, right? Because the environment itself of that factory is polluted. And if we deploy the manpower in that particular industry, then it can prove to be hazardous, right? So we can go for this kind of AGV. Now talking about the automated storage and retrieval system. Now in our earlier session about FMS, we had discussed about making the machine automated. That is easily possible with the help of CNC machines. Then we talked about the automated material handling system, right? In which the conveyors can be used, but that can be operated with the help of different automations. Then we can also use the automated guided vehicles to just carry out the movement of the material. Now, talking about the storage and retrieval system, this thing also required to be automated when we talk about flexible manufacturing system, right? So this is a particular setup of automated storage and retrieval system. We will be having a stack kind of arrangement for handling or storing the particular workpieces. This stack arrangement is called as a storage racks. Then we will be having a transport devices, which is used to just locate the workpiece at particular location of the rack. Then we will be having a pickup and delivery stations. Pickup stations, from that particular point, this stacker crane will pick up the material and it will place inside the rack. And then we will having a delivery stations. Stacker crane will take the workpiece from the particular storage and it will deliver to the delivery station, right? We will having the storage and retrieval machines. This is stacker crane, which is actually acting as a storage and retrieval machine. Then lastly, a computer control system in order to control all these departmental activities of storage part, right? In normal manufacturing industry, you will find the manpower which is actually dealing with these things, right? But in most of the FMS system, we are having the ASRS system. In our Gujarat itself, we are using this in the case of Banaskantha dairy, right? In most of the dairies, even nowadays, they are using this kind of storage retrieval system. All the milk bags are being stored in this particular way, right? In a stacks, right? With the help of this storage and retrieval machines. Now, let us talk about tool management system. Because, all the things we need to make automated. So, tool is also a thing which has been either subjected to wear and tear, right? So, we need to understand the tool supply system and tool monitoring system. Talking to the tool supply system, we are having either single tool magazine in a machine, we are having a multiple tool magazine. We may have interchangeable tool magazine, main and auxiliary tool magazines, and lastly the tool highways. These are the things which has been provided in a machine in order to replace the tool, right? Whenever the machining in the tool is required or the tool has been broken out, we can go for this kind of thing. But second aspect is more important, that is a tool monitoring system. We are also calling it as a tool condition monitoring system, which is just taking care of this different things, that is tool wear and tool breakage, right? If we know about this tool wear and tool breakage, we can predict even the life of the tool, right? Now let us understand how to find out this different thing. Talking about this tool wear monitoring, we are having this two different ways. First is a direct method and another one is an indirect method. By checking the resistivity, we can check if tool wear part, then it is called as a resistivity. If we are using some optical method, then it is called as an optical method. Third one is an optoelectrical method also, just in order to find out the tool wear. But we are more focusing on the indirect method by finding out the cutting power, force, vibration, acoustic and the tool temperature, we can find out the wear rate. Now let us understand how that has been possible. Right? First one is a cutting force method. Now whenever we are doing processing with the help of tool on the particular object, if we mount the force sensor over here, then we can find out the tool wear. Say for example, if you are cutting the particular object, any force sensor has been mounted. Now suddenly if the force sensor is indicating higher reading, right? Now that is possible only the tool part has been broken, right? Tool tip is broken, so obviously more force, as the surface contact has been increased, so it will show more force, right? That is actually the indication of tool wear part. The second one is a tool length. If you measure the length precisely whenever you are doing the cutting operation, see this tip has been in contact with the workpiece. If we are taking the example of drilling machine, this drilling tip and the workpiece is in contact, so obviously the length part would be zero if you measure this thing. But If the tip is been broken out, so obviously it will indicate some length. So this is how you can predict the breakage of the tool. The third one is a current loop. So what we are actually doing is the cutting tool and the workpiece, we are connecting that to the different terminals. So once it is forming the complete circuit, it will show the current, right? Once the tip is been broken, obviously the circuit would also get broken, so it won't indicate any current. So this is how we are just predicting that tool tip may have broken. The fourth one is a airflow method. Now what we are going to do over here is, if this is a cutting tool, we will pass the pneumatic supply of air from one of its end. Okay, that's airflow. And at the another end, there will be a pneumatic switch. So what will happen, once this particular switch is receiving the airflow, then the switch get pressed and it will indicate something in the machine control unit, right? But whenever there is obstruction of tool in between, the airflow won't pass and the pneumatic switch won't get pressed. But see, for example, if this tool has been broken, so in the second case, it is easily seen that air is being passed, the switch has been pressed, and it will indicate something over this machine control unit, right? Which is actually the indication of breakage of the tool. The last one is the infrared beam. So the concept of infrared beam is similar to the airflow method, but instead of this airflow, we are using the beam of light, right? So if the beam of light is being passed and it is detected at the other end, then obviously the tool is being broken. But yes, if the beam of light is being just cut with the help of this tool, then obviously you won't receive the infrared light at the other end. So that is indication that the tool is working in a proper way. Now let us understand the coordinate measuring machine. Now, as the name suggests, this coordinate measuring machine is actually used to find out the different dimensions with the help of coordinates. So in that particular setup, we are having this particular probe. But first of all, let us understand that why we are understanding the CMM machine in the FMS part. Now we are going to the quality part, right? Even the quality part of the product is being checked automatically, then the no human intervention is required. In the entire setup of the particular plant gets automatic. So for that, the CMM machine can be very useful. In such setup, we are having one particular probe. This has been shown in a broader way over here, that the probe part has been touched at the different parts of the workpiece, right? As per this measurement, as at what particular point the probe has been touched, that value, XYZ value, will be shown over here. And from that XYZ value, we can get the dimension of this particular object. So we can check the dimensional accuracy of the variety of different parts with the help of coordinate measuring machine. Now let's talk about the last topic of FMS, that is flexible fixturing, right? Which is used to handle the different workpieces, right? We are having the first, that is a modular. Modular means you can make that thing very easily and as per your requirement. The second one is adaptive. Based on the particular workpiece, you can fix that particular part. And the last one is that phase change and the programmable. Okay, so these are the different fixtures which is possible with the help of programmable means based on your workpiece, if you are programming the fixtures which is actually used to handle that particular or used to hold that particular workpiece, that is programmable, right? So if you hold the workpiece with the help of even automation, then the entire particular manufacturing setup become flexible, right? That's all for the today's lecture and this particular chapter.